solving quadratic equations is not something we have to do in much detail in the SAT, but we do need to know how to find the roots. That's basically all we need to do. We don't need to know the quadratic formula, minus b plus or minus b squared, blah, blah. Don't need to know that. Just need to know if you're given some kind of quadratic equation, how do you find the roots? So let's imagine we have x squared minus 4x plus 15 equals 12. Now, you could try to do some things like, you know, add 15 or subtract 15 from both sides or make this equal to. But what all you need to do is get everything to one side so that you can factor it or unfoil it. So let's subtract 12 from both sides. We'll get x squared minus 4x plus 3 equals 0. So now we need to say, all right, I know the first terms are going to multiply out to x squared, so that's going to be x and x. But I need two terms that add up to negative 4 and multiply to positive 3. So usually start with the positive 3. That's the easiest way to go. So what numbers add up, multiply to positive 3? Well, it's either 1 and 3 or negative 1 and negative 3. And we know that negative 1 and negative 3 are also going to add up to negative 4. So this is going to be my factoring. Now this equals 0, so really what I want to know then, if this guy equals 0, the whole thing equals 0, or if this equals 0, the whole thing equals 0. So I need to split this up and say, when does x minus 1 equal 0, and when does x minus 3 equal 0? And that's when x is 1 or x is 3. So my two roots in this example would be 1 and 3. Notice also, whenever you unfoil, you can refoil and make sure that you did it right. So x times x is x squared. X times negative 3 is negative 3x. Negative 1 times x is minus 1x. So negative 3x and minus 1x is negative 4x. And then negative 1 times 3 is positive 3. Negative 1, negative 3 is positive 3. One other little note. I've seen this come up in some questions of the day, though I haven't seen it come up very often in actual SATs, but just in case, it's finding the axis of symmetry. So if you look at a parabola, and I talk a lot about parabolas in SAT math tactics, it's a symmetrical shape, right? There's a certain dividing line down the middle that cuts the thing exactly in half, and this right here is the axis of symmetry. And to find this, the first thing you need to do is get into the ax squared plus bx plus c form, and that would be this guy over here. Once you do that, all you need to do to find the axis of symmetry, here's another thing to remember, the axis of symmetry is x equals minus b over 2a. So in this example up here, it would be minus minus 4 over 2a. Well, a here is 1, so 2 times 1. So we get 4 over 2, which is 2. So if I were to draw this parabola out, I would see that the halfway point would be at x equals 2. And that makes sense because notice the roots are 1 and 3. So right in the middle of those roots. That makes a lot of sense. All right, so that is just one minor thing about parabolas and quadratics. Not super important, but just in case it comes up, you'll have that in your knowledge bank.